everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new FIFA 21 video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play the 4-3-3 attacking formation, in my opinion of course. I'm going to show you what tactics I'm using, I'm going to show you the instructions, what kind of players you need. I'm going to show you that with the national team of France. I think that's the best team to use it in online seasons, but you can also use it in career or in ultimate team if you have similar players like this. But first of all, I want to thank you very much for watching. Of course, please drop a like under the video if you think this video is useful for you. You can also subscribe to my channel. It's free to do, of course. I'm doing lots of tactic videos, tutorial videos, also videos with gameplay in it. And I'm going to stream online seasons on Twitch or maybe in the future on YouTube here. So my Twitch link is in the description. So if you're interested in that, you can click that and follow me over there also. And then now we are going to start. Here, this is the formation, the 4-3-3 attacking formation. So you have four defenders, of course, two central midfielders, a central attacking midfielder, a left, a right winger, and a striker. What kind of players I'm using? Well, goalkeeper, it doesn't matter that much for the tactics, of course, but here we are using Lloris. Mendy is the right defender because in France national team there is not a really good fast right defender, so we're using Mendy. He has a weak foot of 5-star, so that's pretty good. Of course, we have two decent center backs with Varane and Lenglet. It would be nice if they are fast, of course, but that is that's for all formations nice, of course. And on the left side we have Hernandez. Then we have two central midfielders, and I really like to have one really defensive one and one really attacking one in this formation. Kante is the most defensive one, of course, and Pogba is the most attacking one. And with the instructions, we're gonna instruct them to do what I like from them. Then we have a really classic central attacking midfielder, in my opinion. That's Griezmann. He is not a central attacking midfielder if you are looking at his possessions, but the shooting is good, the passing is good, the dribbling is good. He has the skill moves. So yeah, for me, he is a really, really good attacking midfielder, especially in this formation, because we are playing really attacking football with this. Then we have on the right side, Coleman, a really fast winger. In my opinion, you need a winger that is pretty fast, that has good passing and has good dribbling. If he has good shooting also, that would be nice, but it's not the most important thing for me. But yeah, Coleman is a really good winger, of course. Then we have a really fast striker also with Mbappe. He has really good shooting and good dribbling. 4-star weak foot, that's really important. And 5-star skill moves is nice to have. Then we have Martial on the left side. It would be nicer if Dembele was in the squad, but he is not in the front squad at this moment. So we are using Martial, but Dembele would be better because he is faster and is better winger than Martial, in my opinion. But all stats are composed to the right winger, of course. He needs to be fast, he needs to be good passing, especially the crossing, of course, and really good dribbling. All right, then we're going to the tactics that I'm using. Because we have really, really fast attackers, I'm going to play press after possession loss, because when you lose the ball, you have fast players, they are going to run immediately after the ball, and because they are fast, your opponent has less time to find a way out and pass the ball. If you have slow players, it would take longer before the players are after your opponent and he has longer time to find a solution for himself. So it's really necessary that you have fast attackers and also pretty, pretty good central midfielders, because they are also really important when you are playing pressure football. And Pogba, he is pretty tall, strong player, also really fast for a central midfielder. So he is intercepting lots and lots of balls. The same for Kante. He is small, but yeah, he is a fantastic defensive midfielder and also intercepting lots of balls. The width that I'm choosing is 5 bars, not too wide, because the 4-3-3 is already a pretty wide formation. The depth is 7 bars, because you want to press really high on the field, and that's why I'm using 7 bars. Offensive style is balanced with a width of 6 bars. Plays in the box 6 bars, corners or free kicks, both three bars, but that doesn't matter for the tactics at all. Balanced offensive style has two pretty good things in my opinion. When you have the ball, when you receive it from your opponent or intercept it, and there is a good opportunity for a counterattack, your players, especially the attackers, will recognize that. They will make some runs forward, also because we instruct them to do that, but I'm going to show you that later. They will make runs forward, you can give them through balls, and yeah, because they are really, really fast, you can create some lovely chances, most of the times one-on-one on the goalkeeper if you're doing a good job, and score your goals that way. But when there is not an opportunity to to counterattack, or when you have a goal kick or something, you don't want those players to run forward all the time, because when you are playing long ball, that's what they are going to do. They are going to run forward, and that's not what you want every time. So balanced, recognize the situation most of the times, and when there is not a good opportunity to counterattack, players will make themselves available, and you are going to play more a bit like possession football. Then we are going to the instructions. Let's start with the right defender. I like to do stay back while attacking, and that's because I'm going out from the scenario that you are using this from the start of the game. And when you are starting the game, you don't want to go all the way in the attack, so stay back while attacking is good. But when you are using this formation, when you are behind, or you set it up in your game plan as the most attacking formation, because this formation is really good to be the most attacking formation in my opinion, you can say join a deck and overlap runs, so he is going to make the runs forward and be extra option for you when you are attacking, but you will be weaker in the defense then, of course. The two center backs are always default for me. Hernandez, stay back while attacking, but it's the same story as for the right defender. When you are using this to be really, really aggressive and really, really attacking, I would say join the attack and overlap run type. But when you are using this from the start, stay back while attacking. Then Kante, stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center, because he is the most defensive midfielder and you want him to control the midfield. And when you lose the ball, he will be a really good central defensive midfielder and try to intercept the balls. Then we are going to Pogba, balanced attack, because we are playing already really attacking football with this. I don't push this to get forward, because he is going forward anyway. Balanced crossing runs, so not going into the box all the time, but maybe sometimes when he thinks that's the best option at that moment. The other thing that I changed is cover center. You don't need to cover the wing. I want him to be on the in the center of the field. But when you are using this as a more attacking formation, when you need to score, I will recommend Pogba get forward and get into the box for the cross. But from the beginning, balanced attack, balanced crossing runs. Then we are going to Griezmann, come back on defense, because he has medium work rates. I really want him to come back when you don't have the ball, because else there will be a really wide gap between Griezmann and Mbappe and Pogba and Kante. And you don't want all those wide gaps when you don't have the ball, because that will be really easy for your opponent to play the ball around. You want to be as compact as possible. And with the comeback on defense, you are sure that Griezmann is coming back after you have pressed, of course, because the pressing is the first thing. And when you can't receive the ball after pressing, everybody is going back, and also Griezmann with this setting. The other thing that I changed is get into the box for the cross, because he's really good in the box and really good at scoring goals. So you definitely want him there when you have an opportunity to cross. Then we're going to Coman. The only things that I changed for him is get in behind and get into the box for the cross. The most important thing this guy must do is making runs at the side of the field, and try to give him some through balls, and after that cut inside yourself and then pass the ball to Mbappe or to Griezmann or maybe to Martial when he's there, and try to score your goals that way. The same for Martial, get in behind and get into the box for the cross. The same, try to make those runs, give him the through ball, try to pass it in the box to an available player and score the goals. Stay central and get in behind for Mbappe. Also, he is going to make those runs. And when he is making those runs, please watch him and give him the through balls. He is so super fast. Nobody can catch him up. You can score your goals. When there isn't an opportunity to give him a through ball, he will make the run anyway. And with that run, he will take the central defenders of your opponent with him. And that way he will create lots and lots of space for Griezmann and for Pogba to play the ball around and create your chance the normal way and not the counter-attack through ball way, as we are calling it. All right, that's it for the 4-3-3 attacking formation. In my opinion, the best attacking formation in this moment. If you need to score goals, try this out. Let me know in the comments what you think of it, and if you tried it out yourself, I'm really curious what your results are. Hopefully you will win, of course, with this. And that's the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. Have a really great day. Bye bye.